वंदे गुरुपद्द्वंदम भक्तबिंदसमित श्रीचैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नितानंदसहोदित श्रीनंदनंदन वंदेराधिका चरणोदयम् गोपीजन समयुक्त बिंदावन मनोहर वाछाकृवश कृपा सिंधुवश पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयति गिरिं यत्किपातमहं वंदे परमानंदमाधवं वृंदावई तुलसीदेव वै पिया वै केशवश्च स्नभक्तिपदे देवी सत्त्वत्वयि नमो नमः नारायण नमस्कृत नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीरे संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेशे गौरीय पात्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरु भक्ति युक्त भक्ति प्रमोदाख जगोद्वरयो धैयम् सदा परिभवग्नमविष्टदूहम् तीर्थास्पदम् शिव विरिञ्चनुतम् शरण्यम् भीतातिहम् पनतपालभवाद्दिपूतम् वंदे महापुरुषते चरणारविन्दम् यत्पादपल्लवनखचन्दमनिच्छटाय विस्फुरजित किमपि गोपवधू सुवदर्शि पूर्णानुरागर ससागर सारमूर्ति साराधिका मयि कदा कृपा करोति श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद स्याद्वैत गदाधर शिवसदि गौरभक्तबिंद श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद सियाद्वैत गदाधर शिवसदि गौरभक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे अजानुलंबित भुजौ कनकावदतो संकीर्तनैकवितरो कमलायताक्षौ विश्वाम्बरो द्विजवरो जुगधर्मपालौ वंदे जगत्प्रियकरो करुणावतारो हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे नमामि गंगे तव पाद पंकजं सुरासुरैर्वंदितो दिव्यरूपं भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासिनितं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानं गंगातरंगरमणीयजटाकलापम् गौरी निरंतर विभूषितो वाम भागम् नारायणो प्रियमनंग मदापहारम् वाराणसीपुरपति भजवीशनाथम् वागीशजस्वदने लक्ष्मीर्जस्व च वक्षसि यस्यास्ति हृदय संविहित त्वं नृसिंहमहं भजे हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. Sri Chaitanya Padambhujo Madhupebhyo Namo Namaha Kathanchit Asrayat Jesham Saupi Tad Gandhabhag Bhavet. Sri Chaitanya Padambhujo Madhupebhyo Namo Namaha Kathanchit Asrayat Jesham Saupi Tad Gandhabhag Bhavet. Gauriya Goshtipati Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, to serve my Paramahansa Gurudev, if I need to go to hell, I can go very easily with due contact. Gauriya Goshtipati Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, to serve Paramahansa Gurudev properly, if I need to go to hell, I am ready to go to hell with due contact. I cannot miss this opportunity to serve Guru Vaishnava. That's one kind of rare chance actually. First of all, I like to give you a reminder that today is the appearance day of Prabhupada Parshad, one of the most exalted personality as the disciple of Prabhupada, Srila Bhakti Saranga Goswami Maharaj. Before starting my Harikatha, I like to pay my prostrated obeisance unto the lotus feet of my Guru Pad Padma and the same unto the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru, Srila Bhakti Saranga Goswami Maharaj, and the same to all of my Guru Varga and to Prabhupada, Gaurakishore Baba, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, all my Guru Varga. Actually, point is that Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada very often used to say this thing, that in the lineage of Radha Anugatha, follow, in the lineage of Radha Anugatha, Trinadapi Sunich is quite natural. In the lineage of Radha Anugatha, Trinadapi Sunich is quite natural. Why? Actually, point is that in Radha Anugatha, Trinadapi Sunich, why is quite natural? Because Krishna himself cannot speak what kind of glorification is there with him. Krishna himself cannot speak. And maximum most, Radharani can speak. It is possible for Radharani to know the exact glories of Krishna in total. And now you can understand one simple thing. Usually we common people, we don't have humble attitude. Because we are full of false ego. We speak the Trinadapi Sunich, Trinadapi Sunich, we speak. But it is not possible for us to get Trinadapi exactly. Why? Actually, point is that as and when we can see the exact glories of Guru Vaishnava, if we can see the excellent position of Guru Vaishnava, if we can realize, then and then only we can shrug our head, otherwise not. One simple example my Guru Maharaj used to say, my son, you go to Badi Narayan, Kedar Narayan, you go. You can go you can see, you can discover what a small creature you are. In front of Himalayan hill, if you stand, you can discover you are actually nothing. Whenever we come in front of a big thing, big, then and then we can have the chance to show some humble attitude. Otherwise, usually we are not going to show humble attitude in front of anybody. Like one example, you can remember I told that Madan Mohan Malabhya, Madan Mohan Malabhya, one of the greatest, you know, Pandit in North India. Actually, Benaras Hindu University, BHU, Benaras Hindu University, was established by him. Big Pandit, so great scholar. Madan Mohan Malabhya is a great scholar, you see. He told himself, in my whole life, I never paid dandavat in front of anybody. Not in front of Supreme Lord, not that. In front of anybody. My head is always straight. I never shook my head. I don't feel any kind of submission in front of anybody. But as and when I come in front of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, then automatically my head become down. Automatically. It's an automatic factor. I don't know what kind of power is there with him. As and when I approach, see his appearance, his grammar, at the same time I feel I am a very small creature, I am nothing in front of him. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur himself told, is for our teaching actually. Prabhupada told, by the advice of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, when I first reach Gaurkishore Babaji Maharaj, I paid dandavat in front of him in his lotus feet. Then I discover I have nothing. Actually, it is for our teachings, actually. Prabhupada is actually eternal Prasad. But still, Prabhupada speaking, as and when I come in front of Gaurkishore Babaji Maharaj, I look his lotus feet. When I see the glories of his lotus feet, then I discover that I have nothing. I am a beggar in front of him. I am just a beggar, I have nothing. So long I thought I am a great scholar. I thought I am from a big family. I thought, Prabhupada speaking, I thought I am from a big family. I took birth in the family race of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. I am so much educated, so nice looking, handsome, so glamorous figure, attractive figure. Now Prabhupada speaking, as and when I reach the lotus feet of Gaurkishore Babaji Maharaj, by his causeless mercy, I could realize the glory and the beauty of his lotus feet. Then and there I could realize I have nothing, I am a beggar. In front of that big exalted sadhu Paramahansa, I have nothing, I am a beggar. So long I thought I have so much thing. Gaurkishore Babaji Maharaj is so great sadhu. As soon as we have the chance to come in front of a big sadhu, and if there is no aparad, then we can realize by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, because self-effulgence I yesterday also told, Guru Vaishnava is self-effulgent. You cannot apply your brain, mind, your education, money power, manpower. You can try to apply, but you cannot get exact information about the glories of Guru Vaishnava. It's quite impossible. His name was Bhakti Saranga Goswami Maharaj. The sloka I started with is very important sloka. The sloka I started with is very important sloka. It's from Chaitanya Charitamrita. Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami speaking, very humble way. Sri Chaitanya Padambhuja Madhupe Bhyo Namo Namaha. Those who are honeybees hovering around the lotus-like feet, Chaitanya Charana Padambhuja, lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Those honeybees always hovering around, because a honeybee is always seeking honey, whereas ordinary, bees, you can find they are sitting in stool also. But honeybee is always seeking honey. So they need honey. So they are hovering around the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. There is makaranda. Makaranda is a Sanskrit word. Makaranda means actually madhu. Sayat in Hindi you can say sayat. Makaranda. So they always like to test. So they are hovering around. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking. If we have the chance to take shelter of such one honeybee, countless honeybees hovering around, but such one of them, if I have the chance to take shelter, partial shelter, not fully, kathanchit asraya se, the kathanchit means partial, very upbeat. If you have the chance to take shelter a bit, not fully, still then you can get the fragments, smell, nice smell, which is emitting from the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Charan Kamal. What to speak about you and me? Actually, I know I am Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, always expressing humble attitude. Purisher kit hoite muishe logishto. First of all speaking, jagai madhai hoite muishe pabishto. I am more fallen soul than jagai madhai. I am more and more fallen than the insect you can find in stool. So what to speak about? This way, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami expressing his humble attitude. And speaking actually, we are human beings, externally. But Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking. Actually, if there is any dog, kathanchit asraya jesam swam pitad gandhavag bhavet. A dog, even a dog. That's why Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami expresses him humble attitude. Sri Chaitanya Padambhuja Madhupe Bhyo Namo Namaha Kathanchit Asrayat Jesam Saupitat Gandhava Bhavet. Even a dog can get the smell, nice fragrant, who is emitting from the lotus feet of Chaitanya Charan. So important thing. Now actually point is that you cannot believe what I mean to say. Even you cannot believe what I mean to say. Prabhupada very often used to speak that in the lineage of Radha Anugatha, Trinadu Viswanich is quite natural. Why I am speaking, that I am explaining. Already I told, today is the appearance day of Srila Bhakti Saranga Goswami Maharaj. Bhakti Saranga Goswami Maharaj, Goswami, you Goswami title you already know, but Saranga is special title, Saranga. Saranga mean also is one kind of, Saranga mean honeybees. Saranga is Sanskrit word, it means also honeybees. So, in Bhagavatam we can find why Parikshit Maharaj going to excuse Kali. That was the main question put by all Rishi Munis. Ho Sutadeva Goswami, why? It was very easy for Parikshit Maharaj, was very influential. He could kill Kali, a problem finished. Why Parikshit Maharaj didn't feel it necessary? Why Parikshit Maharaj didn't feel it necessary to kill Kali? That was the main question. And the answer given by Sukadev Goswami is that Parikshit Maharaj is Swaranga Iva Sarabhuk. It's written in Bhagavatam that Parikshit Maharaj is Swaranga Iva Sarabhuk. Saranga Iva, Iva mean comparative degree. Saranga Iva, Iva mean like. That Parikshit Maharaj is just like a honeybee who is going to collect honey from flower, whereas you know or don't know, I don't know. The honey also having poison. Prabhupada writing, flower. Inside flower, honey is there, also poison is there, you don't know. It is the duty of honeybees to collect honey from flower. Some lutakit, in Bengali or Sanskrit, Prabhupada writing lutakit, one kind of special insect, is going to collect poison from that. Follow what I say. So Parikshit Maharaj was very, very intelligent. It's not material intelligence here. Whereas Parikshit Maharaj enjoying full kippa of Krishna. Even inside womb of mother, even when Parikshit Maharaj was there inside the womb of mother, that time also he could see inside womb that Krishna with wheel wanted to cut that, you know, Brahma Astra weapon, Brahma. Now actually Sukadeva Goswami speaking that the king, I mean Parikshit Maharaj is Saranga Iva Sarabhuk, is just like butterfly who cares little about what amount of poison is there in flower, he is going to collect only honey. So Kali is full of problem. But Kali having one nice quality, everybody, all sadhu, they are always singing this glory, Kittanad eva krishnasya mukta sanga param bhajet. All we have the chance to sing the glories of Krishna, I mean Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, we can do, and we can cut material bondage. No Maya can do, Maya cannot do any harm to us. We cannot be in trouble. We can cut Maya, we can go out of this Kali. So Bhakti Saranga Goswami Maharaj is just like a honeybee who is going to collect honey from the lotus feet of Prabhupada all the time. Follow. This way actually I started with this point in the lineage of Radha Anugatha. Trinadu Viswanich, this word is quite natural. It's quite natural. Why? Because they could see the glories of Prabhupada, the lotus feet of Prabhupada. First time when Srila Goswami Maharaj have had the chance to look the lotus feet of Prabhupada, then and there he could realize he is a big and spiritual giant. It was in which place? Dhanbad. That time was engaged in government service in Dhanbad, a railway officer. From then, he started serving Prabhupada all the time. Today I want to prove one thing, that why it is quite natural. Those who are in lineage of Radha Anugata wife, the same thing I wanted to prove yesterday, but time was very limited, I couldn't speak properly. What I wanted to prove yesterday? I wanted to prove yesterday what Prabhupada wrote in his Swiss Vaishnava. Vaishnavi pratishtha tate karanishtha tahana korile ravive lourav. Lourav means hell. If you are going to ignore Vaishnavi Patishtha, then be sure you are going to hell. Vaishnavi Patishtha Tate Kore Nishtha. Mr. Min, you cannot ignore Vaishnavi Patishtha. On the contrary, you will have to show honor. Tate Kore Nishtha. Nishtha means you should have affinity for Vaishnavi Patishtha. That Vaishnavi Patishtha is related to my speech today. Follow what I mean to say. Vaishnavi Patishtha Tate Kore Nishtha Tahana Kurire Ravive Rourav. You can remember I started with one point. What I started with one point? Jagat Guru Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told to serve one Paramahansa Gurudev like Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj, to serve the lotus feet of such exalted sadhu Paramahansa Gurudev Srila Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj, I am always ready to go to hell with due contact. I don't fear. Always and every time I am ready to go to hell. You can think there is no Trinadavi with Prabhupada. Why I want to repeat this point? Because I want to prove that is called actual Trinadavi. When Prabhupada is expressing this way, this mood, that is called actual Trinadavi. You want to become servant of the servant of the servant of the servant of a pure Vaishnava. That is called actually Vaishnavi Patishtha. People think Vaishnavi Patishtha we should not take. But Prabhupada wanted to prove that Vaishnavi Patishtha we must accept. Without Vaishnavi Patishtha, without honor, if I am not going to show honor for Vaishnavi Patishtha, then be sure I am going to hell. In the whole life of all our Guru Varga, like Srila Bhakti Program Keshav Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Kumu Santu Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Saranga Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, be sure 100% Vaishnavi Patishtha was there with them. Mean 100% inclination unto the lotus feet of Guru Pad Padma. When it is possible, when you can see the glory, exact glories of Guru Bhargava. So actually, you can pass this kind of judgment that Srila Bhakti Pragan Keshav Goswami Maharaj is very strict. He is speaking so harsh. Is not actually Vaishnava, no Trinadavi is there. You can speak this way, Srila Santu Goswami Maharaj speaking very hard. Actually, he is not Trinadavi. You can speak this way. But I can prove like mathematics, 100%. I can prove like mathematics, 100%. That Trinadavi Sunichi mood is there, 100% with them. You can also remember, I was discussing this point. Until and unless you are 100% inclined to the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, you have no right to speak about that absolute truth. You cannot feel power. to speak about that absolute truth. Not possible. Because you can fear. You are not established in Vaishnava etiquette. Vaishnava Pratishtha means, first of all, you will have to become a pure servant of the servant of the servant of the servant of a pure Vaishnava. That is called Vaishnava Pratishtha. Any amount of Pratishtha coming in the life of a Guru Varga, they wanted to prove in front of me, my son, I never accept any Pratishtha. Why? Just now you told Vaishnava Pratishtha we should accept. Yes. But what is your realization about Vaishnava Pratishtha? You know? What do you mean by Vaishnava Pratishtha? Vaishnava Pratishtha means, Prabhupada speaking, any kind of Pratishtha coming in my life, they are worshipping me, giving garland, worshipping me. But believe me, I am not going to accept their honor, that respect. Any amount of respect they are showing to me, I just pass on to my Paramahansa Gurudev. And Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj is also going to pass on this honor and respect to his Gurudev. This way, in parampara, you can find all, you know, honor, respect, everything going unto the lotus feet of Radharani, original Guru Tattva. Those who are not established in Rasa Tattva, for them Baldavaji Maharaj Akar Guru Tattva. This most important factor. This is called actually Vaishnavi Pratishtha. I can give one example. Actually very important thing. So Prabhupada speaking, Vaishnavi Pratishtha Tate Karo Nishtha Tahana Kurile Rovivar Rohurab. 100% true. If I like to do Harinam in a solitary place, Prabhupada speaking, Nijjanare Ghare Tava Harinam Kevala Kuitab. You are going to do Harinam, you like to prove that you are a big exalted sadhu. You like to keep yourself in a solitary cell and you like to do Haribhajan, Harinam, you like to prove. Like Haridas Thakur, you are a big sadhu. But be careful. You can go to hell, you cannot do bhajan properly. Actually, achar and prachar, two type of thing we find. Two. That day I was, yesterday I was also speaking the discourse between Haridas Thakur and Sanatan Gosai. Achar kare keho na kare prachar. Prachar kare keho na kare achar. Achar prachar namer karo. Achar prachar namer karo dui karjo. Tumi sarva guru, tumi jagater arjo. Sanatan Gosai speaking, both you have, Baba. Both you will have to do achar and prachar. Both achar and prachar, both you will have to do. You are doing. So, achar and prachar, if both there with an exalted sadhu, is good. Only achar, no prachar, that is very dangerous. And without prachar, achar is there, and if so, actually, point is that achar and prachar both, if there, Prabhupada wanted to establish this Gaudiya Siddhanta. Prabhupada wanted to establish this Gaudiya Siddhanta. Actually, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself also, when last 12 years Mahaprabhu wanted to show us the excellency of Gopi Prema, that is different. Those who are at all having some common sense about Rasa Tattva, they can feel. But for all common people, Mahaprabhu whole life, starting from Gaur Lila, whole life expressing Sankirtan. Harikatha, Sankirtan, everything which is open to all. Actually, this way Prabhupada wanted to prove that we Gaudiyas, we have our duty, both will have to do acharan and prachar. time cannot permit today because my senior god brother all coming. He can discuss some point. I can speak one incident through which I like to prove that how humble Srila Goswami Maharaj is. I like to prove one incident I can speak. So I can prove that the Trinada Viswanich is quite natural in the lineage of Radha Anugata. They are all in the line of Radha Anugata. One day actually Prabhupada went to Allahabad. Many incidents I don't like to speak, Maharaj can speak. In Allahabad, Prabhupada established one mart there, you know, Gauriya mart there. There one day one big police officer came. He is having DIG, maybe this kind of degree, I forget. That time he came in front of Prabhupada and started putting question in front of Prabhupada all the time, one by one. Prabhupada went on giving answer to his question one by one. One by one. But he was full of false ego. He was not at all ready to confess what kind of judgment Prabhupada is going to give. He always want to get logical interpretation by Prabhupada giving both, because only logical interpretation cannot stand. Sometime we are also going to give some logical interpretation. Sometime, finally to break his false ego. Not that logical interpretation final. That's why very often I like to speak, logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of that absolute truth. So that time Prabhupada went on discussing about that, you know, so many tattva, but that man was not at all ready to accept his, you know, tattva siddhanta. Finally, after 2 hours, he gone, and Prabhupada was feeling so bad, because today in my life I am missing, I am going to lose 2 hours time, my valuable time of Krishna Bhajan, I am giving for him. And Goswami Maharaj, almost in the evening over, 7 o'clock or 8 o'clock maybe, coming back in temple, first of all entering into the room of Prabhupada and paying dandavat, then look at Prabhupada and asking, what happens Prabhupada? Why you are so, you know, your mood is, what happens? Then Goswami Maharaj speaking, today I lose my valuable 2 hours time. What happens? But one, you know, DIG, like one pardon officer came. He started doing argument with me. I went on giving answer, but he was not at all ready. So I'm very sorry, I lose my 2 hours time and loss. What the name? What is the address? Prabhupada, give me right now. Then Prabhupada say, he is a big officer. Prabhupada give the address. Then and there, Goswami whole day doing seva, and after that coming, no prasadam, no what, nothing. Then and there take the address and name and run to his house. Anyhow, and you know, he is calling that man from downstairs. And that man ultimately coming out, he started speaking in English, like, you know, fire. You are going to die. You don't know with whom you meet. His name is Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. You are going to lose everything. Right now you will have to go with me to beg for pardon. Otherwise you are going to lose everything. So, and Goswami Maharaj's figure was so glamorous and full of bhakti. Immediately he catch that man and come and pay dandavat in front of Prabhupada. He confess for his, you know, beg for pardon. This kind of power was there with Goswami Maharaj. So many things, I have no time to speak anymore. And he was sent to foreign country to preach the Chaitanya Vani. How, when, we'll have to discuss this point. But we have no time at present, time is limited, Maharaj coming, this Maharaj is coming, so I will have to stop here. If time permit, someday I can discuss all about his you know, unique leela. Vancha kalpadurvasya kipasindu bhavacha patitanang pavane bhavishna bhyo namo namo.